by the taste of the sand, I'd say we're in ancient Egypt.
I just had the weirdest dream that we were invading the bathroom again. Funny you should say that, because we are.
Robocop, the Terminator, Captain Curtin, Darth Vader, no pants, Superman, every single Power Ranger.
The bringing together of Central and Western Europe laid the foundation for the continuance of what is now known as the Carolingian Renaissance. Although the constant warfare, the expansion of Frankish rule and the Christianity over such a large area ensured fundamental unity throughout the empire. Each part of the empire developed differently. Frankish government and culture depended very much upon individual rulers and their aims. Ghana formed by the 8th century by exchanging gold from the forest of West Africa for salt or dates from the Sahara or for goods from Mediterranean North Africa. Feudalism consisted of kings, nobles, knights, and peasants, in that order. Ghana literally means king. It's basically a dictatorship. Although the king was worshipped as a god, politically, the government taxed gold and salt that came through the empire, making it the empire it was. Later, Islam spread to Ghana. Islam was not the empire's official religion until the 11th century, when the Islamic traders came to Ghana. They were treated very well and not persecuted for their religion. Modern-day historians believe the Franks possessed a multitude of forces, which geared them toward horse theme advancements, such as the plow and horse-powered mules. Islamic traders brought camels to the region, a very essential part of Ghana's economic structure. Ghana was the first empire in Africa to produce stone settlements. Metalworking and ceramics also developed in the empire.
imagine what